हेलो
ओके यस
करो।
ओके ओके सो वी हैव टू स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट थिंग व्हिच इज द फुट प्रिंटिंग. ओके सो बेसिकली फुट प्रिंटिंग इज नथिंग बट इट इज द मोस्ट कन्वीनियंट वे फॉर एनी हैकर्स टू कलेक्ट द इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट एनी सिस्टम और एनी टाइप ऑफ डिवाइसेस और नेटवर्क और एनीथिंग. Because foot printing is the first main topic, or you can say that the first main steps you have to take in for finding the information. So the two different things is the one is foot printing and second one is the information gathering. Basically, both are same, but the difference is on one point. Like in foot printing, you are using different type of websites or different type of tools for gather the information. But in the case of information gathering, there are two types of information gathering are present. First one is the active information gathering. And second one is the passive information gathering. The difference between these two is, suppose you are working in a company and you are the actively member of that one company and you want to gather the information about that one same. So you are the active information gathering, but you are not working in the company. You are connecting to the some other person to find out the information of the different company.
Yeah.
That means you are passively connected.
Yeah.
So that comes under the passive information gathering. So here in the PPT, I describe these things, like what are the information gathering and what are the active and the passive information gathering. Next is that one, how can we use the different type of tools for finding up the information? Like we are using the Nmap, Sublister 3R, Dimitri, Inspector. There are different type of tools are present for finding the information. But basically Nmap we are using in the case of only in scanning networks. Like suppose you want to scan your networks, that what type of port numbers, what are the services are working in your system, so you are using the Nmap, because Nmap is a very important tool for scanning networks. But in the Windows we are using the Zenmap, and in the Kali we are using the Nmap. Both are the same, but the function are different, because Nmap is working on the CLI based and Zenmap is working as the GUI based. Okay, so we have to find out the information on the different bases. Also, there is a tool Multego. Multego is the very important or very famous tool for the information gathering, because in that one you have to find out the information about all the DNS and all the things are presented here. Like suppose 1 minute. In the Multego, you have to make a graph, and if any person wants, so you can import the graph as well. Like what type of information you have to be gather. So here only you have to search the Multego. Wait, it will be open.
This certification for the ethical hacking, how many years valid that is?
3 years.
3 years, okay.
After that, you have to renew that one. But this is not important that you have to renew that one, because one time when we got the certificate, so that not means after 3 years, I'm not the hacker.
Okay.
But the person, that one who can renew that.
Yeah.
Okay, so in the meantime, we have to learn about the footprinting. So basically, footprinting, we have to be classified in the 6 parts. First is the website footprinting. Second is the network footprinting. And third one is the email footprinting. After that, footprinting through Google, DNS footprinting. And last is the footprinting penetration testing. So in the website footprinting, you have to know the information about any type of website. So here are different type of tools. I placed it here. You have to only copy this one and go to the Google and paste it here. Like suppose you want to gather the information about any website, so you have to only enter website informa.com is the tool. Here you have to be like suppose I want to information about the youtube.com. Here you have to be search. It give you the all the information related to the YouTube. Like suppose it can created on the 15 to 2005. It can expire on 14 to 2022. It's the owner is the Google LLC, hosting companies, all type of IP are associated with that one. subdomains, DNS, any type of information which you want. Like suppose you want to see the Google owners and the associated emails. So you have to click here. Here all the information are presented here. Okay, now the thing is that one, it can expire on this one. So what does it mean? That YouTube is not working after that one date.
Expire, right? Expire.
Yeah, basically expires, that means there is a two things. One is the domain and second one is the hosting. Okay, domain is that one like the youtube.com, google.com or any type of things which is present inside the domain. Hosting is that one where you put your domain. So the hosting is expired around 14 to 2022. That means YouTube has to be renewed their hostings. Hosting is that
one. Yeah, hosting. It means hosting will expire, right?
Yeah, hosting will expire after this one.
Maybe date, in this, YouTube, many other other website also there are, right? In,
yeah, there are different types of domains that are present.
Yeah.
So you have to renew that one. If you want to check another type of information, you have to click on state and details. Here is the traffic rank, Alexa rank, all things are presented here. So there are different type of tools which I mentioned in this one doc file. So you have to use this one. Whose domain tools also give you the same, but the different thing is that one, webarchive.org. webarchive.org is basically working as the time machine. Like suppose from the very starting, like when the YouTube is working or the making, so it can be give you the all the wayback machine for that particular time to this one. Like suppose I want to search for the YouTube, enter. Here it shows you all the graphs, like from 2005, the YouTube started, and from the 2021. If you want to see the screenshots of any time, like suppose I click on the 2006 and 2006, 6th February, I want to see. Click on that one, it will be open. Wait. YouTube look like this one in the 2006, okay.
Okay.
So it can take the information of all the things. Like suppose you want to take
all website we can find from this.
Yeah, all website. Yeah, all website you can find out. You can only be search here the domain. After that, when it started, it can show you all the hierarchy, and you can click on that one. After that, you can see all the screenshots, or you can see that all the snapshots. Okay, it can take. And next thing is like suppose you want to copy some websites. Like suppose I think you are using the sgtrack.com or the website ripper copier. Like suppose you want to that any website which you are looking like, and you want that, okay, I make the same website. So you can use the sgtrack.com. sgtrack.com is also the tool. You can only copy this one and go to the Google if you want to download the tool. This is the sgtrack.com. If you want to download, so you have to click on the download. Your system is to be 64-bit, so you have to click on this one to download. I already downloaded that one, so that's why I cannot be click on that place. 1 minute, I show you. This is the sgtrack.com. You have to be open this one. Like suppose you want to download any website, so you have to be click on the next, and here you have to write your project name. Like suppose any website name you want, any website which you know that which is very short.
Download any website means what? It means all the contents of the website?
All the content of the website with the code also. If you have some knowledge about the coding or something, so you can change the website on your own. Any website you know which is very short type of pages or something? Because in that time, no one website is in my mind.
Okay, can you type gulftimes.com?
Gulf Time. 1 minute. I should open that one first, Lena.
Gulf-times.com.
Okay,
gulf-times.com.
Okay.
But this is big, not this small.
This is the website?
Yeah, this is the
very big website. It contains most of the pages. No? But don't worry. I can copy this one, okay, and copy and go to the sgtrack.com. After that, here you have to be like any project name you want. Like suppose I write first here. Then next, here I have to be paste the gulftime.com and next, finish. After that, it can copy all the pages and all the things. It takes some time, like suppose it can contain this one by its size, na? So it can take more time. After completion of time, it can copy all the, firstly, we completed all our footprinting. If it completes, I will show you that what data it will get. Next is the email footprinting. In the case of email footprinting, you have to be know, like suppose.
Better for time being, cancel this website. Cancel this website.
Cancel?
No file? What? Yeah.
It will take more time. Like it's
more time.
Okay, no
there
problem.
There is other reason also. That's why I told.
Okay. No issue. Basically, this is not the part of the tracking. So don't worry about
that.
Okay, so basically HTTrack is working like that one. Suppose you want to copy any website. So you can go to that one website and after that, paste the URL here. It can copy all the website with the code also.
Yeah.
So you want to check something, so you can be here. Next is that one. Suppose you want to know about the email footprinting. Email footprinting is that one, like suppose when you do the messages on the WhatsApp, so you got the double tick here, which is the blue tick. So you know that, okay, I have messages to be delivered that person and you that person has to be read that one messages. In the same case of the email tracker, when you install the email tracker, which is the Gmail tracker for email, you can download that one from the website. So in that one case, when you send any email to the person, so that email will be tracked. Like suppose when that person read that email, so you give the green double tick. That means you have to know that that person has to be read your mail.
Yes, yeah.
Okay. Next thing is the iptracker.org. That means you want to track the IP. So you have to copy this one link and paste it in on the Google. Enter. Here is the iptracker.org website is presented here. You have to be only, like suppose I don't know where the IPs belong. Only we have to click on the track IP. It shows you that this IP tracking location is belonging to the India. And all the information are to be given in the this one side. Like this is the IPv4 version IP. It is the public IP, which is the class A range. And it is belong to the Dehradun, Uttarakhand. All the information are presented here that what the timing and all these things belonging to that. Okay. Okay. One more thing I want to ask you, like, you know about that all the IPs classes and all these things.
Yeah, we know that.
Yeah.
Okay. So tell me, what are the difference between the public and the private IP? With the example.
Private means internal our organization, and public means outside that. Suppose that is a public IP means any website and other things. Okay, that is the public IP is there, right?
Mm-hmm.
And
public IP we are using internet actually mainly.
So
private we are using inside the organization.
Inside the organization.
Okay. So, okay. Good. Next thing is that one. What is the difference between the TCP and the UDP?
TCP, transmission control protocol, it is actually connection oriented.
Yeah.
Other UDP is not, means the connection is not required,
transmission control protocol.
There will be acknowledgement also, there will be TCP, but UDP, there is no acknowledgement. Means if you are sending any data, so that means we will transmit the data, we are not sure that data is reached or not.
Can you please give me the real life example or anything which can be described it more well? Like what type of acknowledgement I receive?
Protocols like
UDP, right? Wait. TCP and UDP, right?
Yeah, any example which you want to give in me, like it can follow the TCP and it can follow the UDP, or any one example
TCP,
which can contain both.
Yeah, this is LAN, that is right. In LAN, that is TCP, right? Local area network. And UDP means.
That means in the WAN protocol or in the any other type of protocol, there is no TCP.
It just is.
UDP, we can say that like DHCP, no, right?
JCP
I
is
also
using that
got
one
confused.
protocol, but I want a real life example. Like suppose okay, WhatsApp is that one which you can say that it can uses both, like the TCP and the UDP. When you are working with the messages, like suppose double tick, single tick, and all these things is the acknowledgement. Okay. So that means it can contain the TCP. And when you over the voice calls and all these things calling, it is working on the UDP. Because suppose when there is a network issues middle and something like that one, so your message cannot be conveyed and you got not any type of acknowledgement, like you are using the voice calls and that person has some network issue or something, so your voice is break, so that means break. After that, you have to again connect to the coil and do your all conversations. This comes under
it
the
means massive,
UDP.
It means UDP using for the message purpose, right?
No, UDP is only we using for the voice calls, and TCP is also
voice,
already
right.
Using for the messages. So WhatsApp is that one real life example which can using on the both. That no, not only the WhatsApp, Signal or the Instagram or anything where you do the both things. The calling using the UDP and the messages using the TCP. Okay.
Yeah.
Next thing is the network footprinting. In the network footprinting, you have to use the same commands which I already told you, that the ifconfig is IP config is for the Windows and ifconfig for the Linux. ifconfig slash all if you are using, so that means you got the all the information related to your network, like suppose Wi-Fi,
DNS,
DHCP,
yeah.
DNS, anything. Ping, you are using the commands for checking that you are present in the in the network or not. Next is the tracert. Tracert is the full form for the tracert is the trace route. Like suppose you want to test like that what type of hops are present between you and different type of networks, so you are using the tracert. Okay, next is the footprinting through Google. Footprinting through Google is the very easy type of footprinting, because in that one, suppose you know a person, so you go to the Instagram or any other different Facebook or any other website to find out the information. But suppose you want to only the doc file or something file which is present on the internet, you have to download. So you have to use the command file type space PPT of the ethical hacking. So when you press enter, so all the PPTs is only presented here. Like suppose this is the PPT, this is also the PPT, that means all the links which is present on the Google, which is already contains, which is only contains the PPT. If you want to select the doc file,
PDF,
so you have to be changed.
Yeah, doc file, PDF, yeah.
Anything you can change it here. So this comes under the footprinting through Google. Next is the DNS footprinting. So tell me, what is DNS?
Domain name service.
Yeah, okay. Domain name service or domain name system. Why we are using?
For finding IP to name. And
yeah,
like...
that is the IP to name and the name to IP. Okay,
IP,
because
yeah.
We are not be learned about all the IPs and all these things.
Yeah,
that's why. So here is a two tools are present, which is a DNS dumpster or the UGET signal or the domain dossier. You can use anything tool. Here you have to be go on the Google and place it here. Here it only gives you the information about the DNS related. Like suppose you want to check any reverse domain IP, like suppose associated to the YouTube or any other website which you want, that what type of IP are associated and what type of name servers or the domain name or anything information which you want. So you have to be only select on this one. All these things will be presented here, like what type of domain are associated with the particular domain, like because every website has their different type of name servers and different type of reverse IP domain also presented here. So it gives you the information about that one. Last is the footprinting pen testing. In the footprinting pen testing, basically you have to do the focus on the two-step verification, like for the Gmail, Facebook. Two-step verification is that one. First is for the OTP and second is for the password, which every person uses the two-step verification. But in that one, third point is the TMWSD or the PrivNode.com. Both are the same, okay. But the interface is different. Like suppose you want to mail a person, but you want that no one has to be doubt on you that you placed a mail or something like that one. So you can use this one. It is the hacker part. Like suppose you are using the PrivNode.com. Yeah. And after that, you are writing something here. Like I write some here. And here is a, some options are present. So you have to click. Like suppose you want that person read it, that mail. After reading it, it will be destroyed. So you can choose the option. 1 hour from now, 20 hours from now. You can, depends upon you. Like suppose when you click on that one, after reading it, it will be destroyed. Here you have to be write the password here. Without password, that mail will not be open. Here you again write the confirm password, then create note. When you create the notes, it gives you the link. You have to be select this one link to the person. Select the link and suppose I open it here. Enter. After that, yes, show me the note or not now. So suppose you are show the note. In the note, you have to be write the password, which I write it here. So I have to give the password to that person that you write the password. And after that, you can read the message. See the message here? Okay, and I have the power to destroy it. Like suppose I write here, destroy note now. I destroy the note. When that person click on this one, so here the note will not be founded here. Okay, so that person has no been like suppose no type of anything, like you can send the message in this one form or anything. So you have the particular permission, like when you want to destroy the note, when you want to send the notes and all these things. All the permission has been in your hand. Like you have to be select a particular password and after that you can send it to the person.
Excuse me, I didn't get this one, tribenote.com. So mm-hmm. how will send the message through that one? That means through any email or?
You can send it through the email, through the WhatsApp, anything, because it gives you the particular link. Well, you see,
it will give you, sorry. Yeah.
I create the note link. Now, so it gives you the link.
Yeah.
So you can send the link by the text messages, by the WhatsApp, or any place which you want.
Mm-hmm.
Or after that, you have the permission like to destroy the note now or anytime. So that person has not been doubt or not have proof, like you send this one message to me.
Okay.
So this comes under the private.com and TSMW are also the same, but only the difference is the interface. 1 minute, I'll show you this one also. Here is, okay, you have to write the message and here you have to write the password and save this message. After that, you can send the message with the help of the link. You can send the message to the person. After that, when the person read it, that one, you can delete that one. It's your upon choice. Okay, so this is all about the footprinting.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, if Multigos works, so I will show you. Okay, this is the Multigo. Okay, here you have to click on the this one. It shows you the new graph. Basically, in the Kali, where connection are less, so it will be work very slow. So you have to be click on this one. Here is the option for the new graph. When you click on this one, you want to the information about the domain names or anything. So you have to be only click on this one. It shows you. Wait. Actually, it wants the license now. It is free, but you have to be login with your mail ID and that one. I will show you on the next day, no problem. In that one case, you have to be click on the new graph. After that, when the graph is open, so you want any information for the Google or for anything. So you have to be only click on the domain and suppose this is the domain bit. Yeah, this is the domain. You have to drag and drop it here. Okay, so this is the Pertiva.com. Basically, Pertiva.com is the domain for the Multigo, that is the owner. Okay, Pertiva.com is the domain. After that, suppose you want to change this one, you have to double click on it and change it. Like suppose we want the information about only the Google.com. When you place it here, only right click on it, it gives you the whole information about the system. That suppose I want the information about the DNS. So click on it, it starts. you see running transformation to the DNS name. That is all the DNS associated with the google.com. It shows you here in the form of the graph. If you want to send that one person, so here you see the import and export option, import and export. So you have to be click on this one and send it to the other person. Wait, it starts the transform to the DNS name and it gives you the all the DNS which is associated with the google.com. Here you see the graph, which is you can see all the graphs and all these things here. And here all the lines are presented at the below. If there is any graph is present, it takes some time to give you the domain name. So wait for 2 to 3 minutes only. Okay, so in the meantime, can you tell me if you have any doubt related to the topics, like suppose we have covered footprinting and the basic type of, you can say that the networking or the basic information about the different type of OS. Any issue or any doubt in any topic?
It's okay, fine. We understood.
Okay, so tomorrow we have to make like that one VirtualBox we have to install, and Kali we have to install. And third thing, where I start your scanning and the enumeration part on tomorrow. Okay.
So this here now, this documents, all the documents.
All the documents I have to share in the group, and you have to read all these things. And tomorrow, also I have given you one site to both of you. You have to do the footprinting on all the sites, and you have to make a document, like the doc file you have to make. And post it into the group, so I have to be checked that you do the right footprinting or not. Okay.
Yeah, fine. So Mrs. Disha, right? You are teaching from Delhi now.
Basically, at right time I am in my hometown, which is the Aligarh, in UP.
Aligarh, okay. UP, okay.
I think you heard about the Aligarh Muslim University, no?
Yeah. Okay. So work from home, right?
Yeah, work from home.
Okay,
so I'm sending all the documents in the group. You can go through with that one. If you have any queries, so you can ask me in the next class. And otherwise, you can do the all the practice. And we can continue on the same time, 5:30, okay, on tomorrow.
Okay. So, Nofal, so what do you think, Nofal? Tomorrow, better we'll install, right?
Yeah, if you are able to install, so you can install this one. Otherwise, I will help you when you are connected in the class. So I will help you to with the sharing of your screen.
Just show one time, okay, how we can install Kali Linux.
Basically, you have to only go to the Google and type the virtual box firstly. After that, you have to click on the Windows host for the virtual box. Virtual box 6.1, you have to download.
Yeah.
Okay.
6.1. I have 6.1. I installed before. I think.
Okay, so you can use the 6.1 VirtualBox download. You have to click on the
We can install it. I think we'll try it.
If possible, so you can try it out. Otherwise, you have
Definitely.
And you can download the Kali Linux from the osboxes.org website. Okay. And you can use the version 2021.2. Okay, not 2021.3. Well, this is the latest version, so this cannot be working in this one.
So can which you, one you said that?
Can 2021.1 or 2? Anyone which you can.
Yeah,
2021.1 or 2, yeah.
Yeah, okay. You can try to download if possible. Otherwise, I will help you in the next class, okay?
Thank you. So how many classes will be there? Total classes, 40 classes.
In the ethical hacking, basically max to max is there 40 classes, but it depends upon you and me. Like suppose you are daily, you can take the class from Monday to Thursday. So I will covering your course as early as much possible.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Fine. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye bye.